So they are once again proving Namastubhyam Vaidhirade Yamaraja Sahodara. They are proving that they are worse than Yama, who just obtains only life, not money. So by that it is happening. So preparation methods, also in India, preparation methods are very slow. For example, there is coastal erosion. Now we have seen tsunami. We have seen what? There is a greater tsunami. We already seen. So now no preparation, no energetic and effective preparation is there. In Europe, all the places, they are having sea walls. They are having sea walls. And they are having also a process of beach fortification. By means, what are the depleted sand or sediment particles, they are replaced by a proper source. So this is also there in the foreign countries. Now Thames, you know that they are having a mechanical barrier which eternally protects that from flood. And we are having the Florida beach restoration process which happened recently. The total beach has been restored. And Netherlands, they are having one delta work which, by which they have constructed a very wonderful bridge against the North Sea floods. Now there is a process going on in Russia, St. Petersburg flood prevention facility complex, it is going on. No such step is going on. So what they are thinking is these things are occasional and they are not repetitive. So if it we can see, or if it comes repetitive, we can see. So they don't believe still that it is a frequent visitor like our uncle or aunt. Still they are thinking that it is occasional and rare in one millennia or one century. So these type of measures, even they are dead slow in our country, which requires more technology share, more knowledge share, and mutual share between lot of people in the higher and upper levels, benefactors and beneficiaries. These three types of shares only, it is going to enrich the situation. So biological, now there are two things, threat from life and threat to life. Biological warfare is a threat from life forms. By using these pathogens, immediately they are making a very great biological warfare, which is enough to destruct this galaxy, not even India or the globe. Now there are a lot of biodefense mechanisms they are invented. Even recently, the Israel University, they have invented a biopen. The biopen immediately smells the fragrance of any such destructible element and reports within 20 minutes. So research is going on everywhere. Problem is going on everywhere. Everybody knows everything. Then what are all the difficulties? So based on these things, I have to come to the conclusive section, saying something from the vision of our Shastras. See, for point number one, whatever that brings death only is considered to be disaster. It is not so. Disaster is something which can bring one immediate death, or it is a slow poison process which can bring death, or totally which makes the presence or life of a person not distinguishable from the death, which makes the person useless, or which makes the person's disastrous worse than nature. So these are all also considered to be the disastrous factors. So death, number one, debilitation, number two, deterioration, number three, and demoralization, four things are considered to be disastrous factors. Number one. Number two, not only we are having these disasters, there are five types of disasters. Whatever you see as a volcano, a tornado, a hailstorm, a cyclone, a typhoon, then mudslide, mud flow, landslide, avalanche, then biological warfare, war, riot, clash, conflict. All of these various things, innumerable things, including accidents, air accident, rail accident, sea accident, road accident, chemical accident, explosive accident, fire accident, superstructure collapse accident, innumerable things that you have listed are not. Everything, these things come under turbulent disaster. There are four more disasters. One is a silent disaster. That is a silent disaster. And the second thing is a decent disaster. Third thing is innocent disaster. Fourth thing is a negligent disaster. So what is silent disaster? That which does not show its face in the society, but exists and totally corrupts the society and totally extirpates the social. Its purpose is known as silent disaster. Innocent disaster is very common. Like it comes as a friend. Somebody told in one conference that necessity is the mother of inventions. Then I told, necessity is the mother of inventions, curiosity is the father, but danger is the daughter. So that which comes very innocently, but behaves and shows its real form, that is innocent disaster. The third thing, it is decent. And to be frank, I don't mind saying that the computer, the IT industry, I told in one seminar on IT administration that there are three problems which totally dump the person's capability and ability to not reach to the multi-spheric regions. One is IT, second is IET, third thing is high score IT. So likewise, this is a different disaster. Totally swindling a person's emotional balance or multi-level organizing skill of his intellectual or cognitive load and skills that is totally dumped in a single area. Now they are researching about occupational therapy, repetitive stress injury, now they are doing research. So there is a golden rule of nature, number one. Whatever you claim from nature, even a single penny, you have to pay with interest for treatment, resurrection, reconstruction or any other thing later. Whatever you get from nature, now they have extracted all the things from nature through industrialization. Industrialization that has created the most possible ways for global warming. Now in global warming research and solutions, they will pay all the industrially squeezed money with interest for research and execution of the global warming mitigation project. Certainly they are going to do. Because nature has a balance, there is a global constant. You cannot disturb that. So the third thing is negligent. What is negligent? That which is considered to be something infinitesimal or trivial in the stage that grows to a disaster. So there are innumerable disasters, and I want to name few of the disasters and conclude this session. Number one, the first disaster is the main reason for the executive difficulty and the arduousness that we are possessing and experiencing in implementing all the policies is known as administrative disaster, which has been given the name as corruption. This is the major problem due to which what the management as well as the detection, research, whatever we are doing, the fruits of our service, either scientific service or social service, it does not reach the society. They are trapped, grabbed in various stages and diverted to various areas. So administrative error or disaster is corruption, and that is now serving as the very noble and loyal servant to all disasters. Till this servant is there, there is no possibility for us to effectively do disaster management, number one. The second thing is social disaster, which is in the form of sentiments and organizations. Sentimental disaster is religious clash and various things, which you know that community clashes, conflicts and everything are there. And second thing, now they have been discussing about the temple disasters. They also come under society. How to organize a group, how to systematize. Those things emerge only when situations arise. That is known as contextual emergence. How to organize and how to benefit. So it must be balanced in such a manner that the system must not be sacrificed. The beauty of the system as well as benefit to the society must be balanced with the equilibrium. And nothing can be sacrificed. Though the talent of organizing the society is not sacrificing one thing. It is a bilateral organization in which the benefit of the system as well as benefiting the society, they are very equilaterally organized and governed. So that is known as social. It is social. The third thing is cultural disaster. Culture does not just rest in a person's external appearance, but the behavioral culture of a person. Now we are seeing a lot of orphanages, we are having a lot of slums, we are seeing a lot of other things like old age homes. Old age homes are good examples for cultural disaster. So these type of disasters, they are also rooted in the society. All of these various disasters, they are caused, they are added to scientific disaster. Somebody told what is the problem of the society and what is the mistake of science and spirituality. Then we gave the answer, the problem of the society is that it is burning. That is abnormity. That it is burning. And the mistake of spiritualism is, it has failed to extinguish. The practical spiritualism is that it has failed to extinguish. And the mistake of the science is, it has added a combustible fuel. When there is burning, spiritualism has failed to put water. But science has added petrol to that. That is the problem. So scientific disaster is a disaster. See, whenever you know that, there is going to be, that is known as insight, deep thought. Whenever you are revealing some sensitive portions like nanoparticles, like genes, like DNA research, genome mapping, eugenics, innumerable things you are dealing with, the fundamental factors of the world. Whenever you are dealing, you must also simultaneously deal with the problems, that is that sociological adaption and reflection. It is science within you. If it goes to a person, then it is subjected to rainwater, is pure. But it reaches the land by passing through a lot of impurities. So science or spiritualism, when it reaches the society, it is also to be considered with the mind setup. The blunders and wonders of human mind and psychological collective mental setup of the society must be taken along with your science or spiritualism. Likewise, the social setup is not prepared. Science is very fast. and society has not developed much. It is having only external development and decoration. Internal